Could a Shogun Free Total War really be in the works? Let's find out. Okay, so the theory originally begins on the CA Discord. They had games listed, such as Warhammer, Three Kingdoms, Troy, Rome, Medieval, Shogun, and other titles. Now, the first three made sense to me. They are still the active titles, but the other three did not. Okay, Rome might be there for Rome 2, but where's Attila? That's more recent. You could argue the player base, perhaps, being the reason why it's higher. But then, why Medieval? And no mention of Empire or Napoleon. Empire still has a decently large player base, one that constantly competes with Medieval 2s. I predicted this early in the year. The Rome chat was a hint that Rome Remastered is on the way. At that point in the video, people clicked off thinking I was crazy. Medieval was either a reference to a then Medieval Remaster or a Medieval 3, or both. And then I sort of ignored Shogun. I just said, and maybe something Shogun later. A few months after making that video, Rome Remastered was announced, and the name of the chat was updated to Rome Remastered, and Rome 2 was kicked down to the other games category. So I've been proven right once before with this theory. Hear me out. Total War began with Shogun 1, reason being it was a balanced time period with interesting forms of combat and all under one culture, meaning units could be copy and pasted from each faction. Basically, it was easy to make, so with less dev time and low funding, it was the logical choice. Then, Medieval 1 was the last game on the first Total War engine. After that, they moved on to the Total War Engine 2. Medieval 2 was the last game on the Total War Engine 2, and then they made Engine 3, also known as Warscape. The Medieval games have always acted as a sign-off to the engine, where they gather everything they have learnt and put it together into one final masterpiece. In addition, we had Rome 2, then Rome 2 DLC, then Attila, then Attila DLC, then Thrones ending in 1066. All true historicals have been slowly building up to the medieval period, meaning it is likely that the next true historical Total War will be set in the medieval world and will be the sign-off for the Warscape engine. I've talked about this before, but had to catch you up. This video is about Shogun 3. If Shogun 1 was the simple game, then what was Shogun 2? This is one I learnt from Admiral Price. Empire failed, Napoleon failed, and so CA, to boost their reputation again, to bring people back, they needed a game they knew would work. Shogun 2. It was a simple design, easy to get through, and would turn out to be a great, well-optimized game. The perfect title to bring us back. Also, Shogun 2 had the shortest dev time of all titles. There's two patterns here. Logically, if we follow the patterns, the next true historical will be Medieval 3, and will be the final send-off for the Warscape engine. Then, the game after is Shogun 3, using a brand new engine. Shogun 3 being a reasonably simple game to make. Like, compared to Three Kingdoms, Warhammer 3, and Medieval 3, Shogun 3, so many 3s, it is kind of tame compared to those others. It would be only logical for CA to head into this new engine with something easy that they are familiar with. Something that, if it was to go tragically wrong, would be easy enough to fix. And it just so happens that the logical pattern also fits the pattern laid out on the CA Discord. I have been Melkor. Let me know down in the comments what you think. Do you agree or disagree? And if you disagree, please provide some proof or data. Leave a like, but for now, meld on.